Hi, Sherissa.
Hi.
Hi, Sherissa.
Hi, guys. I wish I could see you in person.
This is almost
just as good, yeah.
Hello.
Hi.
Hi.
Hi, feeling.
Ready?
Thank you so much for doing this from home.
Yeah.
Yeah.
It's actually like a Christmas card outside.
Yeah, I know. It looks so beautiful.
Inspiration. There you go. Outside on the card. This is going to be a little bit tricky for me because we actually closed the library early today. Yeah. So I had to wrap up my whole scene that I had set up on set in the library and kind of bring it home. So right now I'm missing like half the supplies I gave you guys. You guys will be set. I'm going to make it work on my end.
When did they tell you you were closing early?
2 hours before.
Okay.
Yeah.
Hey, people.
2 hours before. There we go. Hello. Thank you guys for joining.
Thank you for doing this. Thank you.
Yeah. Well, so I'm just going to wait till more people filter in. I already got some messages from people that are actually going to filter in a little later. But how many of you came to my first card making class? Nobody. Oh, okay. So the first card making class that I did was before everything went wrong with the world. And we were physically in the library. And it was basically just, I had a whole supplies laid out and I had a table full of cards that I had already made. I also had some templates, had a slideshow, and just, it's basically just me setting a foundation to set you guys up for success and trying to inspire you to do your own card. I'm not going to tell you what card to do. I'm just going to show you that simple is best. Maybe show you a little trick of some of the cards that I've done. And then you can just take free reign. And because you know the people that are close to you, what they love, the colors. So I support everything I possibly can. And you can follow along with me or just be on with them for the interaction and just go your own route and it'll be totally fine. Let's see if there's anyone else waiting in the room. Yep. Okay. So happy holidays, everybody. It's really in full swing with our little blizzard outside. Yeah. So let's see. I don't even know how to start this, actually, because this is so weird being on a laptop. I'm usually just interacting, talk to you guys in person. So just work with me.
Doing great.
So some of the cards that I have done, I actually gave away already, but I'm just going to show you. I have, let's see, 1, 2, 3, 4. I have about 5 cards here that have a totally different take on, I guess, what you would think a card can do. Super simple. That's always something I try to just like keep it simple, keep it personal, and don't be too hard on yourself if you mess up. So this is one that I do have. It's kind of fun, actually. Makes noise. So this is one that I made out of beads. Simple white cardstock paper that I've given you guys plenty supplies. And if you guys are artistic, I figured you could have some kind of sewing string in the house. And I don't know where I got these beads from. I think that I found them around the house, but you basically just trace a tree, obviously. And then you just pick out the bead. So it's like tree and ornaments. And then that one bead is the star. And I basically just sewed right into the paper. And because it's cardstock, it's thick, it's not flimsy. I gave you guys some thick paper to work with. And you can't see it so much in the back because it's so thin. And I tried to, it's gray, but if you have white string, that would be best. Green would probably look really nice. And I just taped it, right? So what you guys would do is when you would trace a triangle, very light, you would basically just sew back and forth with your dots. Oh, let me admit this person. You would sew back and forth, adding your beads, jewels. You can do sequins. You can do anything that you can probably sew through. And you just keep going all the way up like a tree. And you would tie a knot in the back and tape it. And so to hide this imperfection, which I didn't do because I need to show you guys, you just take another piece of paper. And it could be a different color, preferably. You know how when cards, when you open it up, it has like another layered paper inside. So you take that piece of paper, you would essentially glue. You can do hot glue, liquid glue, glue stick, glue it inside. And that way, when someone lifts it up, they don't see this. All they see is the pretty paper. And then you can write your little message. And so that's how you do something simple like that. I mean, I think it's a different take. It's cool that they can appreciate, they can have fun, they can play with it a little bit, because it's like, what's a card? You just put it down. But this, they'll just talk to you the whole night. Merry Christmas, happy holidays, this is fun. So it's cool. So that's one take. I'm just gonna put this over here. We can revisit this later. Ooh, a lot of people are coming in. Another take. Which is super, super simple. And you would think that it would be very, very hard. Is I also gave you guys, I'm just trying to close the screen out. I gave you guys watercolor cards. So most of you guys have like a nice little stack like this of goodies in your, so the watercolor card is going to be thicker. And what you'll notice is that it has like, it feels a little rough. So that's the one that you're gonna wanna use. And what I did here, I'll wait till you guys fetch it. What I did here is I basically just took painter's tape. I couldn't give you guys painter's tape because I wouldn't even know, they don't sell like little rolls. But if you guys have, you can use. If not, then carefully use the regular tape I gave you guys. I just taped a box, right? And then I took some watercolors, preferably, I don't know if you guys can see the color because for some reason my light is very warm in here. But the color is basically, it's like different flavors of like pink and mauve. And it's because I made this card specifically for a personal friend. And so what I do is that you just go layer after layer, wait till it dries. And you can always leave some gaps to make it look stacked. So the trick with this is actually, this can work for many different things. You can use this as a present, as a birthday cake. So it's just a simple square. You layer it in any color that you want. And I believe I gave you guys watercolor sets. So you can use that as well. So you basically just layer it. And the trick I did, and the other one that I gifted is, let's do this really quick on screen because this is actually just an example template. Let's see, let's use some black. We're gonna use some black. Take my little clipboard here. I feel so prepared now. So the trick you're gonna do, right? Let me bring this down so it can level out. So let's say this is acting as a present. So what you're gonna do, and this is like line art, so the sloppier and more organic, the better it actually looks. The trick you're gonna do is just basically draw right on it, right? And then you create some rows, some strings, and it looks very, very, it looks like something you would pay $5 for, honestly. And then if you wanted to, right? If you wanted to, if you have good handwriting, if you know how to calligraphy, faux hand lettering, all the good stuff, you can put happy holidays or whatever you want to put up top to mom. And then like same trick with the inside, if you guys want to insert a thinner piece of paper just for the lining. So that's also a very simple and cool trick that you can do with watercolor. I think I did that pretty cool doing it like this for you guys. So that's another one. Very easy. And by the way, if you guys have questions or if I'm going too fast, just unmute yourself, chime in. I'm just trying to go over some basics so that we have enough time throughout the class to actually work on some cards together and you guys can show me what you're doing and we can just go back and forth. And then so another one, I actually did this for Valentine's Day, but I think it would work for Christmas as well. It's basically a heart that says, I love you a million times to form the heart. So what I've seen on Pinterest, what people doing is like this one that I showed you. If you form a tree, which is a very simple shape, or you can form a Christmas present shape like a square. I don't know. It's the holiday season. Everybody celebrates something. So whatever pertains to you, try to draw a simple shape. And then what you're gonna do is you're gonna fill it in to make the shape out of what matters to you. Happy holidays, Merry Christmas, Happy Hanukkah, you know, Festivus for the rest of us, all of the good stuff. Mm-hmm. And it's simple and it's gonna take a lot of time if you wanna be like perfect about it. And then after you're done tracing it out, just erase whatever pencil marks you did to outline the shape itself. And then that takes a lot of time. Just you wanna keep it like very simple in the front or not, whatever you guys prefer. But because the middle, once you're making the card, you're gonna wanna write in it. And I love writing like novels in my cards and paragraphs. You're the most important person to me. I love you so much. This is this and that. Or if you wanna put money in the card or a gift card, which actually brings me to the next one. So this one, I was always intimidated by, but it's actually the most easiest thing. This is like a card within a card. So the card itself is this. And then when you open it, it has either a message inside. Usually this is something you would use to put a gift card in. You just double side tape it right there, write a little note on top or on the bottom, and then you close it right up. Trying to show you guys with that actually. And there you go. So to make this, I can actually show you guys on screen, but it's basically just four circles and one square. And what's cool, which I'm gonna try and do for you today, is that you can do two circles that have the same pattern and then two other circles that have a totally different pattern. And then it's like you have two cards in one, and then the middle can just be simple. Red, white, off-white, whatever cool papers you guys got in your goodie bags. And so that's how that works. And then if you have ribbon or twine, you can just tie a nice little bow around it to make it, I mean, it's obviously gonna stay closed, but just to make it look like full, because this is the envelope and the card rolled into one. And you can make this personalized by size to your liking. So if you just grab something round in your house, I love coffee, and just shape it, that's gonna be the size. This is actually smaller than this, but you can do it that size. You can do really, really small if you wanna be cute, but I don't suggest that because it might get a little stressful. So that's the last of my cards, actually. I did something personal, which I'm still kind of working on. My husband and I love, I'm whispering because he's in the other room. My husband and I love games. And so he loves green. So I did a very, very washed out green on the watercolor card. I faced it this way. And I kind of taped off the letters, and I'm gonna try and make like Scrabble pieces on there. So I just gotta write it out with like black. And then when he opens it, there's gonna be a nice little cute note inside. But just, that's an idea. Just, you know, if you wanna think of something that's totally cool, personal, it could be quirky. And that's that. I think I spoke for like 15 minutes. So how are you guys feeling? What are your thoughts? You wanna hop into it? Do you have any questions?
A couple of questions.
Sure. Mm-hmm.
So I think this must be the watercolor card because it's the only white, but I couldn't really tell for sure. Like you said that it has texture. I didn't notice anything that has texture.
So you, I believe I gave you two sets of cards. Let me try and pull out one for me. So this one that hasn't not been folded yet that I was gonna
right.
you guys to fold, that is not watercolor.
Okay.
You feel the texture on that. It's very, very smooth.
Right.
So if you take another one, there should be another one in there. If you kind of juxtapose, there's like a slight difference, but you can feel it. If you look closely, it kind of looks, well, I was gonna say water, like it has ripples on the paper.
Yeah. I'll look for it. The other thing I found was this looks like a picture frame.
Yeah, so that's the other thing. That's what I'm saying. Like you guys have actually more supplies than I do because I was supposed to be in the library, but we closed early today. So that's one of the supplies that I actually have here. So I think you pulled out a white one. Some of you got white, some of you got black, some of you got both. I just bagged it, just however. These are actually, this is not watercolor, but it can act as it just because of the way that it is a little texture. So it will grab onto it. This is another unique way that I wanted to let you guys personalize your card. So if you have a really cool old Christmas photo, if you want to just be funny, you can insert it. So these are actually supposed to be picture frames. You actually just put photos in it and you put it, it's supposed to be like a picture frame card. But it doesn't only have to be pictures. You guys can put anything you want in here. If you want to just size it up, there's a little opening here on the side. If you want to do some art and then slip it in, or if you just want to use some of the cardstock or the pretty paper as background, you could slide it in and then write on it. And it'll kind of be like framed phrases or however you guys want to write your card. So I'm letting you guys be the masters of your own masterpiece. There we go. Anything else?
So I noticed some of the cards stock has these little hole punches. Does this mean anything?
Well, it just means, textures. I mean, so that's how it came. Okay. And works. Okay. It came in like one of those things you have to store in a hole.
Oh, okay.
That's how I ripped it off. I didn't rip it on the perforations because I didn't want to ruin it.
And if it doesn't have a crease, do you have any recommendations for how to make a crease? Wow.
Yeah, you can score it. I actually left my score at grade, but take something as simple as something that's a little, like this is a basic pen.
Mm.
You can score it by just drawing.
Yeah, with a ruler. Yeah.
Yeah, with the ruler, okay. Exactly. If you don't want to fold it in half, because that cannot always be accurate as well.
Right.
Anything else, guys? Are we ready to just
We don't have any watercolor paper.
Are you sure? I gave everybody paper. It could also be a big one.
Ooh.
It could be a regular big cardstock paper. That's
the only got this like glossy. Really soft one.
Okay, so that's this guy.
So this is not watercolor.
Do you guys have watercolor paint?
Yeah, we do have watercolor
paint. Oh, so then you guys should definitely have the set.
You mean in the bag? No, we didn't find the paint. We just got the watercolor.
So that means somebody went in your bag. I think moving forward, Heidi and I were kind of debating because it is a lot of work when you get like 20 to 30 people signing up. I'm going to have to write everybody's name on a bag because we've had this issue before that bags will go missing, people signing up for classes. So
Can I just ask you, is this the watercolor paper?
I don't know. Does it feel textured?
Yeah.
So then it most likely is.
Yeah? Okay, thank you.
You're welcome.
What about this one?
Technically, you guys can use any paper for watercolor, but watercolor paper just grabs it more and it will dry better. So if you do use this for watercolor, it'll be fine. You're just gonna have to leave it there dry for a bit. Cause that's how I started out. I'm learning with you guys. I wasn't well-versed in all the art stuff. So I didn't know that there was watercolor card that you can do. And I found it, I ordered it for you guys, but the struggle is real when you try to do it. But it is possible if you
feel
if you're determined.
I also don't have watercolor paper in my kit, but I have watercolor.
Yeah, you see?
So.
Well, you can use heavy cardstock and do watercolor cards. It just will warp. I've done
it. It'll warp a little bit, unfortunately.
A little bit, but it just adds to the charm.
Put a book on it. Weigh it down after you're done.
What are the paper that has patterns on it? How are we supposed to use that? You know, like
so. Ooh, that's what you got. So when I did this program the first time, I had people do different shapes, and I should have actually brought those cards in. It's basically you can use it for cutouts. You can use it for backgrounds, like what I said with a card like this. If you want to cut it out and put a nice little lining, that's upside down. If you want to put a lining inside, or if you wanted to make that, see, just like this.
I just used it, inside one of these frames. I just and put the
one. Okay, that's
it's good. Basically just to let your.
Yeah, I think same. So mine is this one, and this is on the other side. So I decided to just put this in.
Okay.
Because you can make your card out of some of the colored, some of the pattern pieces I made, if you wanted to just glue it onto the card template itself. There's a lot you guys can do.
Is this you?
That is me.
Okay.
That is me. I'm currently working on that.
Cool.
Some of these textures are so beautiful. Like you could do like an offset here.
Yeah. See, I love that. I love what you're doing.
Yeah. This is so pretty.
That's also why I gave you guys, see, I don't have that, but I have the actual card template. I gave you guys a card template. So you can also. An envelope template. So you can use some of the pretty patterns that I gave you. If you want to cut that template out and trace it over the pattern, you can make a card envelope out of one of those pretty patterns. If there's enough paper, I mean, granted, I know I gave you guys as much as I could, but you know how they have the cards that have the lining inside?
Mm-hmm.
Do blank white with a little bit of lining, like as you fold it. Looks so pretty.
You could also cut out the design paper with the patterns into strips, like how you made the tree with smaller to bigger. So you could line it up as a tree for the holidays.
Yeah, exactly. You know, I'm going to pull up, we can't do screen sharing anymore because of something that happened during Sip and Paint, if you guys know. So we don't do that anymore on Zoom calls. But let me actually pull up. Okay. So all the pretty pattern paper that I gave you guys, you can do something like this. Let's wait till it.
Mm-hmm.
You can cut it out into.
Oh, nice.
They're right on there. Happy holidays. Because I'm pretty sure you guys have, if not all of these patterns, some of them. So that's a cool idea. So I like exactly where you were going off of that, you can cut strips and just line them up to make a tree. That's something I like with the patterns. You can also cut them into circles and make little Christmas balls. or ornaments. I don't know why I said it that way.
Cool.
Let's see. There we go. This is something I was trying to, showed you guys. Oh, a little watercolor Christmas present.
Is that the one you did with painter tape?
Yes.
Okay.
So that's my version. You can't see it that great because it's like a glare. I'm just gonna start. I'm gonna start doing some stuff. You guys can start doing your stuff and we'll just chime in with the questions.
Ooh.
I'm gonna go shovel some snow, Dana.
I'll do that. Thank you.
four circles and a square.
I'm doing this to send things to these kids in the hospital, because St. Jude and somebody else are like, I can't remember the name of whatever it is, but I'm just sending it to
make it hard for someone.
That's really sweet.
Sherissa, the card stock. Do you score the inside or the outside? I think it's the inside, right?
It's the inside.
Okay, thank you.
Inside. I just made an envelope, guys.
Pretty.
This is wrapping paper. This is me making do with what I have.
I made a tree.
Oh, I love that.
Ooh, I love it.
It's with the handwriting inside.
Oh, with the handwriting inside.
Oh, wow, that came out really nice. That's
so great.
Yeah.
I made a little gift box. I mean, I still have to with the stripes of the different papers that we had.
Watercolor?
No, this is the different papers, the different...
Oh. Yeah.
Oh, that came out really beautifully.
Yeah.
How are you going to do your bow?
I'll just use a marker and do the bow. And then I was thinking maybe make some little small Christmas balls.
Oh, perfect.
Yeah. Make them like if they're hanging.
Yes.
Beautiful.
Super random, but if anybody else has a million little green things from their fake tree like I do, I'm going to be using some glue or paint and then sprinkling that into either a tree or a wreath or, you know, background, I guess. I don't know, but.
That's actually a really great idea.
We got to make do, right? We got
to
make do.
Yeah, and does it still have a scent to it?
It does. Which is amazing because it's fake, but it does still smell like the things that I sprayed it with. So, you know, it works out.
That's like beautiful. Good idea. Thanks for the tip.
Sure. I love that it's got the leaves on it too.
I know, isn't it awesome?
And then oh my god, I love it.
That's some.
So did you just fold the paper and then make the frame on the inside? How did that?
No, it came as a frame. It's a card.
Yeah.
Frame
so.
And I just, oh.
I most of you should have either white or white and black. If you picked up supplies, this was
okay.
Yeah, I get white. Oh yeah, let's see what you get.
Okay, I'm going to see if I can find any more pretty paper around the house. And I'm going to try and show you guys how to do this one. Really quick. Just put the logo on for now. Okay. For some reason, I can't find any color cardstock paper in my house. I gave you guys all the good stuff. So we're going to use wrapping paper. So I'm going to angle this down. Oh, I love that. That is so nice.
Yes, I think I'm missing one string, but yeah.
I didn't even notice. Could have been a snowflake or something.
Yeah.
Snowball.
Yes, and now the inside, I'll figure something. I did the writing on one part.
Mm-hmm.
Maybe something else on the other. Let's see.
Yeah. This is so nice, guys. Okay, so I'm gonna try and show you really quick how to do this gift card, card envelope hybrid thing. I'm just gonna angle this down. It's my little work area. Okay, so it's actually really simple. You're just gonna take something circular. For me, it's my beautiful can of Bustelo coffee.
Yum.
Yeah.
Yes.
And I think I can probably only get 3 circles out of this, but you're gonna need 4. So you're just gonna go ahead, trace and cut them out. That's the simple part. Tedious, but simple. Let's see, 1. Oh, I can actually get all 4 out of this.
So Sherissa, it's not one piece. You're cutting out the circles and the square, and then you're going to combine them?
Yes, exactly.
Oh, that's great.
That's why I felt the need I needed to show you, because this looks very put together. But it's,
I know.
If you look closely, they're actually 4 separate circles layered.
Oh, now I get it. Oh,
yeah, and so what you do is that after you fold them in half, well, I'll show you the step by step, but it's basically
sure.
So it's 4 separate circles and just cut them out.
And that means they could be different patterns too.
Yeah. So I'm going to try and show you guys that and do it the crafty way. But if you guys already have the paper, I suggest the color pattern paper you have.
I only have the brick of my coffee. I feel like I should have sprung for the can now.
That's so funny. Well, I mean, I chose the can just because it's such a perfect,
it's like a good size.
But I mean, anything, you can use a it's just going to be a really big card.
Now, how does the size of the square relate to the size of the circles?
So when you put the circles together to actually like bind one another, when you fold it in, the square that it makes is the square that you have to trace onto a piece of paper.
Okay.
And you cut out.
Got it.
Have to take away like a centimeter just so it can fit inside. So I'm gonna show you guys that. This is tedious cutting these circles. I need an X-Acto knife.
And should the weight of the circles and the square be the same?
The weight?
Weight of the paper.
Oh, no. No, the square can be light. I suggest that the circles are thicker cardstock material.
Okay.
Just because, yeah. I saw you, Shai. One more to go.
Sherissa?
Yes.
Okay, so I did the tree. Whoa.
Oh, there it is. Right. No.
Put it in front of you.
To the left. Right there, Mom.
Hang on. Oh, let me take this off. It looks good. Hold on. Let me. Virtual background.
What a virtual tree going on there with special effects.
Here we go. Oh, here we go. So I did Mary and Bright. I put a little gold border. Amazing. I used acrylic because I didn't have gold watercolors, but I did that. Okay. And then I did this one. That's the little box. It looks like a packing.
I love that.
Yeah. Okay. These are great. And then only because I really like this, I just did this really quick.
You did that. Oh,
beautiful.
Oh, and I want to go over your hat.
Okay. So anyway, that is beautiful. Yeah.
So, thanks.
So, beautiful, yeah. Colors,
guys. Three.
But I want to try that circle thing, but I was looking for a pound can of coffee from my entire building. We're all, I get Starbucks, it's in a bag. They get the bricks of the Basteo. And I want to melt down all my candles from last year that are like this tall and still have a scent, but no wick. So, yeah. Anyway, I'm going to be.
Can I give you my address?
You have cans?
So I use the coffee can because it was what I had. But like I said, you can use a cup. If you have a round mug, I mean, it's just going to be like those kind of cups that kind of look like soup cups.
I got a lid to a ball jar. I'm going to go grab that.
I got my four cutouts, guys. I'm just going to, should I give it a,
sorry.
I'll wait. Okay.
How this works. Sherissa?
Yes.
How do you know how these double-sided tape work?
Do I
need to peel one side? Because it's only sticky on one side.
All from Leonia, NJ.
All right. If it's only sticky on one side, maybe that's the first strand since it was circled out. Maybe just try pulling like a good couple.
Oh, okay.
Let me try.
That
seems double-sided, kind of.
It's gonna be a little tall.
There it goes.
Oh yeah. Oh yeah, I found it. Thank you. I was trying to peel the other side off, but I couldn't find it.
Oh, I want that tape.
This is just tape.
I think I'm going to use this. It's just a lid from a ball jar for the circles.
Okay. It might come out a little small, but just so you get the hang of it, if you can try test it out.
Yeah.
And then you'll be able to redo it again.
I had a slightly bigger lid, but I can't get four circles on my colored paper. But I really like this. It's really cool.
You want
this must be your private stash. It's got designs on both sides.
Oh, wait.
Thank you.
Oh, maybe you should use this tape.
Yeah, we don't know that.
I'm doing that.
Actually, I could make the circles different colors, couldn't I?
Yeah, that's what I was going to suggest. Are you, if you're set on it having just one color, you can make two circles. Nope. Colors and two circles, two other colors.
Oh, that's a good idea. I like that.
Nina, that's what I'm doing. I'm doing two different
colors. What do you think about these together? These are cool, right?
I think those are great.
Yeah, okay. I'm going to try that.
I'm going to show you how I'm doing mine.
Thank you. And then I'm going to make a square with this little box.
So. That's actually perfect.
How did you think of that? Okay, now I gotta get my big circle.
Oh my God, we don't have much time left.
Okay, I mean, I'm home.
Yeah. No, actually, I have another, believe it or not, another meeting at 7:30.
It was only 7:30,
I can't remember.
The library closes at 8. I mean, we can keep going. You guys wanna sign off if you need to. I'm gonna go until I finish my card and then I'll let you go.
You must have like a busy day.
Yes. Yes, I do.
You guys opening tomorrow?
Yes, it's gonna be a delayed opening.
Yeah.
But we are gonna be open most likely.
Wow.
Well, clears because we were already prepping. Ice, salt.
Yeah.
Everywhere, and our maintenance and security are going to be like shoveling already. I mean, I heard someone on the call even say they were going to start shoveling, so you got to keep track. You don't want like 2 feet of snow outside.
I think it's going to be a quiet day. Most people are going to stay in till it's
It's going to sound like New Year's Day. That's always
the
brightest day.
Lucky me, I have a 9:30 doctor's appointment.
Oh boy.
Better call ahead to see
schedules.
I already did today. I said, are you guys coming in? Cause like, you know, I can get there, but
yeah,
it's going to be weird.
Maybe it'll be fast. Cause no one else is going to go.
I don't know. It's going to be certainly going to be interesting. I mean, I called today and I said, listen, you know, I can trudge over there. But are you, you know, is the doctor coming from out of town or whatever? So
yeah,
they said they're going to be.
Okay. The good news is I got 4 circles on here. I just had that. So
yeah, stagger them.
This is a really cool idea.
I love this so much. I'm also really into the color that I came up with, these color combination. I can't wait to show you guys.
Yeah, this is the perfect snowy day activity. Thank you.
Oh my God.
Yeah.
So I've got 2 circles. I'm gonna combine this and this.
Ooh.
Like weird gray, because it's, you know, so dull, but the green just pops it out, you know?
That's good. I like that.
Good color.
Thank you.
Sherissa, are we folding the circles in half for the square?
Yes. So I'm waiting till everybody gets their in order.
Okay.
So good. We're going to carry you out on our shoulders.
Well, we should send pictures of our cards so you can put them up on the bulletin board.
Yes,
so this is what we did.
Really should.
Missed out.
We would love to use that.
They have a contingency plan for tomorrow. Are you going to find out in the morning?
Well, I'm going to hip replacement tomorrow.
Yeah, that's if they show up. Fortunately, things don't always happen as planned. Right.
Whoops.
So, Sherissa, was there an incident at the recent sip and paint?
Oh, yeah. So,
really? Oh, gosh.
So, the last sip and paint that we had online for those that signed up, we got hacked.
Really?
Yeah. So, that's why I wanted to show you guys like a Pinterest board of card ideas just to get your mind flowing.
Yeah.
Now I've turned on all sharing abilities. And that's just, you just gotta do
away
with the phone. So the, but yeah, we got hacked. It was unpleasant. The good thing was that everybody still signed on. We had to remake a private Zoom event and then email everybody.
Yeah.
Just started like 45 minutes later, but.
Oh my goodness. Success. I don't understand what people are like, I guess they don't have enough to do already.
Yeah, like, I don't understand too. I mean, there were kids on the call.
Huh?
It's a family-friendly event. There were kids.
I know.
I was just like,
here's my little combo story. I did the scoring.
Oh, that is so genius. I love it. You see what she did? She did a little like window.
Yeah, so now I'm thinking maybe I have to come up with a really clever closure. And like maybe I'll put something on the middle because it's not perfect, but Jane, you know what?
You could add some like ribbon or something on.
Yes, exactly.
Side, like glue a piece.
That'd yeah, I cool. was thinking even of a bauble, a little bauble, yeah. and a loop. You know, that should you work. Know,
I thought that first, but then I'm thinking, how would I even make that? But you know what? I'm underestimating your genius over there. So. Bauble it is.
Bauble. She's going to crochet that sucker right up.
You're a better woman than I.
No.
I cannot crochet for my life, but but I can still make friendship bracelets. That never dies.
All right. I've never done one of those.
Sherissa,
what do we do with these circles now?
Okay, does everybody have their circle ready?
Or circle? Here's what I made.
Got him. Oh, that's great.
That's nice.
I love the band at the bottom. It's so pretty with the green trees.
Okay, so.
With do we need a square ready?
No.
Yeah, I haven't done my square yet.
Because everybody's square is going to be different, so I can't tell you how to make it.
Is there a ratio of circumference to square?
Apparently not. I asked her also. Sorry we keep repeating ourselves, but hey, you know.
It's okay. Look, so what you're going to do is you're going to fold all of your circles in half.
Oh.
Okay.
And that's not so easy.
Could you walk me through that?
You're going to have to score.
I'm joking.
I want those circles to be perfect. Do they have to, whoops, they're flipping all over the place now. I just have to be less scaredy cat with these materials. You'd think I'd be, was working with the like gold lame or something. I noticed one side is textured and the other is not. Should you fold the textured part in? Does it matter?
It doesn't matter. It's up to you. I mean, I believe everything I've given you is cardstock. If not, it's a little thicker than normal paper.
Yeah.
I'm going to bring you closer. Okay, so here's the trick. When you guys fold it in half.
Yeah.
Oh my goodies on here. You're going to line up.
But the white part is the inside, right?
Well, for me it is because I want my pattern to be on the outside.
Well, that's what I mean. So if we want we have to put the whatever pattern side or texture goes on the outside.
Then. Yes, you fold
okay.
it.
Okay.
Yes.
All right. Sorry about that.
That's okay.
I got it now.
Gold lame. That's great.
So, I love it.
Hey, you never know.
You don't with the gold baubles and the crochet.
How Yay. Okay. All right. And then you have to find just any old piece of paper.
Well, I mean, it could be, or it could be a nice piece of paper.
Oh, really? Okay.
Yeah, so I'll show you.
Sherissa, we glue it down, or we tape it? The four circles.
I'd suggest taping it down because you're not going to see the back part, because you can glue or double side tape the square right on top of it.
Okay.
I'm going to show you right now. Let me just grab some.
Okay.
So is it important what kind of paper you use for the square? I'm not quite sure I understand.
So it is and it isn't. I'm going to show you right now.
Okay.
That's dry.
Okay, here I'm back. There we go. All right, so I'm just gonna take this down really quick because I don't want this to fall apart. So I just did a simple, so I connected all the circles. You just layer them in a square and I just taped down the middle. You see the little glare there? So to measure your square that's gonna fit perfectly in here, you don't actually have to, it doesn't have to be perfect. So you wanna fold it. Fold your square, fold your piece, and then you're gonna basically trace this
right
onto a paper, but cut within the trace.
Right.
Because
so
you
actually
want it to
that fit. The little piece that you tape is gonna become invisible. It doesn't matter what it is. The initial square, because you can always put something on the inside.
Yeah, we're putting something right on top of here.
Yeah. So it doesn't matter so much.
No.
Could you show it again, please?
Sure. Show how to put this together?
Could you just hold up what you did? Oh, yeah, there you go. Okay. Oh, I see. So the little circles hang over. They hang over halfway.
Mm-hmm.
And then you're going to trim the outside of the
circles.
Where? Right. Okay. Oh my goodness.
So this is okay. I'm gonna show you guys right here. So this is what I'm gonna do really quick. So I'm gonna fold it to make a square. And then I'm just gonna take this. And this is what I have right now. So this is what we're gonna use. I'm just going to trace the square, and it's going to come out bigger because you're tracing around it. That's why I'm telling you to cut within your tracing. So there's a faint square here. You guys can't see it, but I'm going to cut just like half a centimeter inside the line. I'm gonna do that all the way around.
So did you need four pieces of tape? You had to tape each square, each circle?
No, what I did was I placed each circle on top of each other.
Uh-huh.
So I can actually just take this out. I'll show you all over again. Cause it's not, you're not gonna see this.
Yeah, cause I think I'm overthinking it.
Okay.
It's complex at this hour.
I'm just like, wait a minute. I'm not sure this is gonna work. I know, in fact, I know it's not gonna work. I don't know what I'm doing.
Okay, I'm gonna show you bring this closer here. So you have your four,
right?
Your four circles.
Okay.
What you're gonna do is that you're gonna put one circle down.
Okay.
Take the other circle and you're gonna try and match up what you scored with the corner of that score to make a 90 degree angle.
Oh, that's it. Okay.
And then you're gonna take another one.
Yeah.
Score it with that 90 degree angle. And then you're gonna do the same thing with the other one.
Okay. And you say one piece of tape is gonna do it.
One piece of tape is gonna hold it all down.
Huh, okay.
And I actually, I want this to be here and this here.
What's the red for, the liner?
For the inside.
Yeah, that's what I thought.
Oh, now I see, okay.
So if there's like, I wish there was a way that I had like a camera that I can like show you guys in detail. So let me just open this up for you really quick.
Well, I consider myself the most mentally challenged, so.
Oh no.
If I can figure it out, I think everybody else is just.
Barely.
You're gonna make sure that everything is kind of like not overlapping, but just meeting. So you don't want these two circles to be on top of each other. You just want them to form a nice square. And then you just take one simple tape. Doesn't have to be big because you're just gonna do it right in the middle to hold all the circles together.
Now we find out whether our circles are really well done.
For extra stability, you can do a little like, because right now it's a little loose. You can do
yeah.
A little. I was just going to say, when you close it, these things open up in the back.
Yeah.
Yeah. So.
So what you're
doing after you tape it, you can maybe glue
it. Yeah, after you tape it, you lift it and you secure it with either a glue stick or double-sided tape.
Yeah.
And then, so I have my little red square and it's gonna fit perfectly inside.
Cool.
One of my circles needs to go on a diet. Getting a little trim right now.
Oh.
Ta-da.
Yeah, so how you guys close it is you're gonna go one circle at a time, and it's like when you close a box. So you're gonna do one, two, three, and then this one goes under and over. So it has
to go flat.
Yeah. Nope.
Other way.
Yeah, other way, exactly. There you go.
Beautiful. I think the trick though is I have to disassemble and make sure all the circles are close enough because they're not behaving with each other.
Yeah, see mine was, I didn't do what she suggested and I didn't secure it to the back. So one of my circles came out, but hey, it just
showed
that I am also learning.
Now we got the hang of it.
Sherissa, this is so much fun.
It is. Actually.
My card making skills just went up tenfold.
You leveled up.
Yes.
There we go. That's fine.
Well, I am going to drop. Thank you so much. I need to find this other Zoom before they give up on me.
Oh, that's right. Wow.
Good night, everybody. Thank you so much, Rissa.
You're welcome. Bye, guys.
Night.
Good night.
Bye-bye. Bye, Sherissa.
Bye.
Hop off too.
Bye. Thank you.
Bye. Thank you.
Well, thanks.
You can send a picture or tag us.
Yes.
I can send it to you.
Yeah. Oh, so pretty. That's so nice, guys.
Thank you. Little acrylic.
Yeah. Oh,
make it pop.
Mixed media makes it textured.
Okay. It does. Take care. Thanks.
Is class over? Am I the last one in here?
No, there's still a million people here.
Oh, okay.
Just class is over, but you can stay.
Yay!
There's still what? 3, 6? There's 9 people here still.
Three.
If you were just looking at me, if you put gallery view, there's a whole array of people. Oh, that's love that.
And this is the front.
Oh, I love that.
I didn't work on the circles because I got hung up on this thing.
Oh, it looks great.
Well, I mean, this class was recorded, so we'll actually be able to
have
it up for you. So,
very good.
Ooh, I love that.
My God. My frame. Oh, look at that. Ooh, gold leaf.
I just realized yours is the black frame.
Oh, yeah, mine.
The frame yourself. I'm just like, everybody's just getting it done today.
Yeah. And
That's so nice, Shirley.
Look at the gold leaf. Oh my God, that's gorgeous.
It looks like the expensive chocolate wrapping paper.
Correct.
Am I right? Oh, okay, cool.
Yes.
Shirley. Hmm. What happened? Oh, he's not talking.
Bye, everyone. I have to go.
Okay, bye, guys.
Thank you, Sherissa. Thank you.
You're welcome.
Bye, Shirley.
Bye, Shirley. Then. See you again.
It's gone.
Quick.
Darn, I'm out of tape.
What? Oh, whoops. You can do double-sided tape, can't you?
Oh, I still have this tape.
Oh, yeah.
It's cooking.
Oh, damn. Oh, that is so small. I love it.
How's everybody doing?
I think we're good. I'm surprised everybody's still on. I should probably end it, actually. How do I get kicked off in case there's another program that needs to happen?
Thank you. Have a good night.
You're welcome. Okay, bye, guys. I'm just going to end it here. You guys can continue your cards on your end. Put some Christmas music on.
Thank you, Sherissa. Because I'm going off.
Yeah.
Thank you, Sherissa.
Bye, guys.
Bye. Thank you very much.